I want to see if we can read for 5 minutes today without talking to our neighbor.
Ashley Duncan is a first-year teacher at San Francisco's Bessie Carmichael Elementary School.
Are you reading the
patches?
Puppies?
Yes.
Which one? What's this one about?
Ashley comes to teaching from a family that stressed education as a means to improve yourself and your community.
I feel that teaching and education is a great way to change the community as a whole. And if you give people the skills and self-confidence to transform their lives, you'll see that effect in the community.
If we can do this by the end of the week, get to 30, Miss Duncan will take you to the park.
Ashley had no trouble in securing a job when she emerged from college. That's because Ashley comes to education at a time when California's public schools are finding it difficult to fill teaching positions, a teacher shortage problem resulting from a number of factors. Nationwide, many teachers were laid off during the recession as school districts cut their budgets. Entering college students who were thinking about becoming teachers saw the handwriting on the wall and focused on other careers. One report says California lost 82,000 jobs in schools from 2008 to 2012. In that same period, the California Commission on Teacher Credentialing says those entering teacher preparation programs dropped by more than 55%. And California was not alone in seeking teachers from the limited pool of available talent.
We are really competing with other states. The shortages are national and especially severe in the West. Nevada, Clark County, which is the fastest growing county in the country, that's where Las Vegas is at every job fair in California, saying, come to Nevada. We have, you know, higher salaries and lower housing costs. So we are definitely competing with a lot of other states.
Stanford University's Dr. Linda Darling Hammond is one of the authors of a statewide report on California's teacher shortage.
Well, we're at the beginning of what's about to become an even more acute teacher shortage, but in the last year it became very severe in a number of districts and in some specific teaching fields, math, science, special education, English language development teachers.
There are two words, and when you put them together, they make one word.
Brittany Yavrom is a teacher at the Encina Preparatory High School in Northern California's San Juan Unified School District. Brittany is one of those who bridged the gap between past layoffs and today's demand for teachers in the classroom.
Well, when I first came into teaching, three years ago, there were very few positions. But throughout my entire schooling, we were told, you know, the baby boomers are going to retire. They're going to go. There's going to be so many jobs available. You're going to get to work wherever you want. And that didn't happen at first. And so we were just scrambling and trying to take any job we could.
So you got that two binary.
While the reality of teachers retiring does open positions for new classroom instructors, experienced teachers leaving the profession are another factor in the shortage we're seeing today. Julie Garrett is looking ahead to retirement after more than a quarter century in the classroom.
There is that stress of, well, are we going to have enough? If we do truly have as many teachers retire as you say they're going to retire, what are we going to do? Are we going to have enough people to fill those positions? And I think we're losing a lot of experience that new teachers bring in their own positive points, but experienced teachers have so much to give as well.
We also have seen that with a booming economy in San Francisco, people have options to go and make significantly more money in the industry. So we've seen a 10% increase in teachers that have left and resigned and gone into other careers.
And some districts like San Francisco face an additional challenge with the high cost of housing. That hits especially hard for new teachers coming in at lower levels in the pay scale.
When I first was moving into the city, it was really hard to find housing. It was nearly impossible. I was thinking I was gonna have to commute. I was not excited about that possibility, but a friend from college knew a friend from work who was having an opening in her apartment, and I got that apartment. It was great, wonderful. Then the rent went up.
If teachers can't afford to live in the city that they want to live in, then they're going to move somewhere else.
Especially with one of my classes, like I know when or what questions that some of my students are going to ask.
Efforts are underway to increase teaching numbers. Dr. Pia Wong leads this education discussion course at California State University. Education classes on the CSU campuses turn out the lion's share of new teachers in California. Here on the Sacramento campus, enrollment levels are improving.
We have been engaged in many innovative activities. The system has provided a lot of support for the teacher preparation program faculty to become familiar with and start to infuse their coursework with the Common Core standards and the Next Generation Science standards, so that when our candidates leave, they can hit the ground running.
Many districts have begun year-round outreach efforts online, along with seasonal job fairs to tap into the pool of those who might be available to teach. Everyone agrees that incentive bonuses, housing assistance, and mentor programs will help to not only attract, but retain new hires. They agree, however, that it will take political will to address a problem that looks to be with us for some time to come.
We do need our politicians as well as our public to think about the fact that this is the profession on which all other professions depend. And if we don't get this right, we're really putting our society at risk in a lot of ways that none of us wants to do.
Teacher training schools in the United States date back to the 1820s, when one of the first normal schools was opened in Concord, Vermont. They were called normal schools because their purpose was to establish teaching standards, or norms. Many of America's best-known universities began as normal schools. Incidentally, Normal, Illinois took its name in 1865 from the Illinois State Normal University, a teacher training institution.